Fighting broke out on Sunday, September 27th, between ethnically Armenian and Azerbaijani forces over the disputed territory of Nagorno-Karabakh. Nagorno-Karabakh is an ethnically Armenian enclave. It's officially part of Azerbaijan, but it broke away as the Soviet Union was collapsing in the 1990s. And the sides, they fought a war in the 1990s and a brief four-day war again in 2016 over the territory. Which today is a de facto ethnically Armenian state that is recognized only by Armenia. We have seen an uptick in war rhetoric and in violence over the past year. There was fighting along the Azerbaijani-Armenian border in July, and war sentiment has really been on the rise in both countries, as has preparations and really very deep and disturbing public and diplomatic rhetoric. What we're seeing today, certainly there is a risk of this becoming a much larger scale conflict. It is the bloodiest fighting we have seen, with civilian and military casualties on both sides. We're also seeing the involvement of outside powers. Russia has supplied both countries with arms. Russia is, however, an ally of Armenia. Turkey has been providing a steep and very strong diplomatic support for Azerbaijan, and the Armenians claim that it is also providing military support. We have seen also an uptick of Israeli weapons to the region, so it is really quite disturbing. This is a region that is geopolitically important. It is a major trading route for oil and gas coming from the Caspian Sea to Europe. It is on the northern border of Iran, the southern border of the very volatile Russian North Caucasus, and Turkey in the Middle East are right next door. So this is a very troubling time. What we have seen is the international community has not been paying a whole lot of attention until just the last few days. We've had very strong statements out of Washington and out of Moscow urging restraint and urging a resumption of negotiations. But the fighting is occurring at a time when COVID is rearing its head again in the second wave in Europe, and the United States is distracted by the upcoming U.S. election. So there is a lack of global leadership right now in trying to quell the fighting, and it is certainly something that is deeply troubling to see.